Welcome dear student for HSC online lecture initiative taken by Kshetra Vidyamandir English High School and Junior College of Science and Commerce. I am Ms. Ragini Singh, Assistant Lecturer of Biology, and today we are continuing with our chapter Human Reproduction. Let's recall what we studied in the last module. We studied about the menstrual cycle, in which we saw the different hormones and different phases and even the changes in the uterus and the ovarian cycle. And the menstrual cycle lasted from day 0 to day 28. On an average, the normal life cycle of the menstrual phase is 28 days. We are dealing with the sexual reproduction. Today module we will study about the gametogenesis. Genesis means formation. Formation of the gametes. Gametes in case of female is egg, whereas in case of male it is sperm. The gametogenesis is the process of formation of gametes in sexually reproducing animals. The male gamete is sperm and the female gamete is ovum or egg. The gametes are formed from primordial germ cells of gonads. Spermatogenesis. Genesis means formation, formation of sperm. The process of formation of the male gamete, that is sperm or spermatozoa, from the germinal epithelium of testes. It involves three phases. The very first phase is multiplication phase. The primordial germ cells, that is 2N, of seminiferous tubule undergo repeated mitotic division to produce large number of spermatogonia. Each spermatogonium is diploid and with 46 chromosomes. So this is the first phase, which is called as multiplication phase. The second phase is growth phase. Now what happens in the growth phase? Some of the spermatogonia stop dividing and they grow in size to develop into primary spermatocytes, that is 2N, due to accumulation of food. In the diagram you can see this is the primordial cell, which is diploid. It undergo mitosis, it means resulting in the two cells. This phase is called as the multiplication phase, where these two cells again undergo mitosis to form spermatogonia, that is also diploid. Once this multiplication phase is over, it enters the growth phase, where it is acting like a primary spermatocyte, that is diploid. Now this primary spermatocyte will be entering into the third phase, that is the maturation phase. Now what happens in the maturation phase? In this maturation phase, the primary spermatocytes undergo meiosis first, because it is diploid and the sperm has to be haploid. So it undergoes meiosis first and it forms secondary spermatocytes. This secondary spermatocytes again undergo meiotic division to form four spermatids, that is again haploid. These four spermatids again undergo the spermiogenesis and they form four spermatozoa, that is haploid. So finally you are getting the sperms, which is haploid in nature. It involves meiotic or reduction division. The spermatocyte undergoes the first phase of meiotic division, meiosis first, leading to formation of two haploid cells called secondary spermatocytes, that is haploid, which are with 23 chromosomes each. The secondary spermatocyte undergoes second phase of meiotic division to form four haploid spermatids. The spermatid is non-motile and non-functional. It gets transformed into functional spermatozoa by the process called spermiogenesis. Very important term. During this process, the spermatids remain held to each other and to Sertoli cells, that is the nurse cell, by cytoplasmic bridges. The sperm heads remain attached to the Sertoli and the nourishment is taken by the Sertoli cells and their tails hanging in the lumen, that is the space of the seminiferous tubule. During spermiogenesis, length of spermatid increases. Centrioles are arranged at primary and distal. Centrioles are meant for the cell division. Mitochondria become spirally coiled and acrosome is formed from Golgi complex. Acrosome is very important because it consists of an enzyme called hyaluronidase. Let's understand the structure of sperm. The sperm is the male gamete. It is motile, microscopic. It is divisible into three parts: head, middle piece and tail. Let's understand what is present in the head. The sperm head is oval in shape, as you can see in the diagram. It is oval in shape and it consists of the haploid nucleus. Above the nucleus, there is a cap-like structure called as acrosomes. It is formed from Golgi and it contains proteolytic enzymes, that is zonalysin, for breaking down the zona pellucidae, and corona penetrating enzyme. This sperm has to penetrate the egg, and for that it has to cross corona radiata and zona pellucida layer. Second part is neck. If you talk about, this is the neck. It is a very short region having two centrioles, the proximal centriole and distal centriole. Then it is the middle piece. This part is the middle piece. It has an axial filament surrounded by 10 to 14 spiral turns of mitochondria called as Nebenkern. This mitochondria main function is to provide energy necessary for the movement of sperm. The tail is a long, slender and tapering part containing cytoplasm and fine thread, that is the axial filament. The axial filament arises from the distal centriole. See, proximal always means first, distal means second, and travels through the length of the tail. It is partly surrounded by the plasma membrane, that is the main piece. The part without the plasma membrane is called the end piece. So these were the four important parts of the sperm, that is the head, neck, middle piece and tail. We will continue with our gametogenesis with respect to the female, that is oogenesis. As there is spermatogenesis, similarly we have oogenesis. Genesis means formation of the egg. It is the process of formation of the haploid female gamete, that is egg or ovum, from the diploid germinal epithelium. It involves the process of meiosis and mitosis. Like spermatogenesis, oogenesis can be divided into three stages: multiplication phase, growth phase, maturation phase. Multiplication, growth and maturation. This is primordial germ cell undergoing the mitotic divisions to get two cells, again undergoing mitotic division to get four diploid oogonia. Then it will enter the growth phase and the maturation phase. In growth phase, what happens? Out of this four oogonia, one develops into the primary oocyte, and this primary oocytes undergo meiosis first, where it forms secondary oocyte, which is haploid, and one polar body. Polar body is also haploid. Again, this both goes to the meiosis second, that is the maturation phase, where it forms one ovum and three polar bodies. So this is the oogenesis of the egg. Structure of secondary oocyte. Now, one important point: when in human, unfertilized egg, when ovulated, that is released from the ovary, is actually the secondary oocyte. It is non-cladoic, that is without shell. If you talk about hen, duck, they all have the egg with the shell, that's why they are cladoic, whereas here it is non-cladoic and microlecithal, that is yolk is present in very small quantity. It is approximately 0.1 mm, that is 100 microns in size. It is rounded, non-motile and haploid female gamete. The nucleus of the egg appears large and it is called germinal vesicle. Here in the diagram you can see this is the nucleus, which is large, and it is called germinal vesicle. And this is not a matured egg, but it is called as the secondary oocyte. Typical nucleus or pronucleus is formed at the time of fertilization. The cytoplasm of the egg is called ooplasm. The cytoplasm of the egg is called ooplasm. It is devoid of centrioles, that is, it is not involved in the cell division, and the egg is surrounded by the various coverings. So if you look over here, you can see the cytoplasm present called as ooplasm, the nucleus present which is called as germinal vesicle. This is the first polar body, this is the, you can say, corona radiata, this is zona pellucida, and this is the vitelline membrane. I hope till now everything was very clear to you all. Now let's see how much you have understood. Your first question is, define spermatogenesis. You can take your time, pause your video, write down the answers and check. Formation of the sperm, that is the process of formation of the sperm, is called spermatogenesis. Name three phases of spermatogenesis: growth phase, multiplication phase and maturation phase. विच हॉर्मोन इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर ओव्यूलेशन? ल्यूटनाइजिंग हॉर्मोन, दैट इज LH. Name three parts of the sperm. It is head, neck and tail. Name three phases of spermatogenesis. Growth phase, multiplication phase and maturation phase. Is sperm haploid or diploid? The sperm is haploid. Let's continue with testing your brain. What is cytoplasm? The cytoplasm of the egg, and it is also called as the ooplasm. Name three phases of spermatogenesis: growth phase, multiplication and maturation phase. Is egg haploid or diploid? It is haploid. So even if this question they are asking name three phases of oogenesis, you can still write down growth phase, multiplication phase and maturation phase. Take down your assignment. Explain the process of spermatogenesis with neat and labeled diagram. And explain the structure of sperm with neat and labeled diagram. In both the cases, diagram is very, very important. Your next assignment. Explain the structure of egg with neat and labeled diagram. And explain the process of oogenesis with neat and labeled diagram. I hope this module was very helpful to you all. Thank you for attending this module. We'll again come back with the next module. Thank you for attending this.